Hello world, it's Siraj, and today I'm going to talk about 5 ways that you can make money as a programmer. Everybody needs to make money. It's just the reality of life. And if you learn how to do it well, your life will be substantially better. So let's start with the first way, contract work. If you're someone who's never earned money before as a programmer, this is the first method you should use. There are people out there that need your skills. You just have to find them. You can find contract work online on sites like Upwork and Freelancer and a few others that I've listed in the video description. Think of your name as a brand, and like all brands, you need to build trust. The way you can do that is by gaining a positive reputation. If your client is happy with your work, you'll get a great review. You want them to rave about you, to tell their friends about you, and if you put in the necessary effort, they will. But how do you get the clients in the first place? Basically, you need to get really good at selling yourself. And that all starts with believing in yourself. That means that given some uncertain environment, like a project with requirements you've never taken on before, you trust yourself enough to be able to figure it out. Before you start asking people to trust you, you have to trust yourself. When you create your profile on one of these sites, you have to sell yourself well. That means every project or past experience that you list should be both detailed and impressive. So if you made a mobile app and you implemented a custom networking architecture, make sure to include that kind of impressive detail. When it comes to picking the type of contract you should work on, it's about what's valuable to the market and what you would enjoy doing. Machine learning is hot right now. Hundreds of thousands of companies and individuals need someone to integrate AI into their stack, or build an app that uses facial recognition, or perform some analytics on their database. There are endless use cases. And luckily for you, not many people understand how it works at all. So if you have at least some knowledge, that's your competitive advantage. You can basically get paid to learn. Once you've either posted yourself as available for work or replied to a contract listing, you'll eventually get interest from a client. You'll then have your first meeting to discuss the details of the project, and your job is to be over-prepared for it. That means do your homework on all the requirements beforehand. Have a list of features in mind and a plan on how to get there. This will be really impressive to your client, and they'll be more likely to pay you well. When it comes time to discuss the payment, don't underprice yourself. You can always negotiate your rate down, but if you start off with a low rate, you can't increase your rate later on. If it's your first contract, just charge a flat fee and pick one that is short term, like a month or less. Research the price for similar projects that have been completed and if the programmer had a similar background to your own. Once you've done 1 or 2 contract projects with a flat fee, you can move on to charging an hourly rate. Always charge market rate or above and increase your rate as you improve. You can also find contract work in person. If your client can meet with you face to face and knows your name, then it's easier for them to trust you. Everyone could use a programmer. Call up some local businesses and ask. If you're in college, you can usually find work on bulletin boards and use the resources you have locally. When I first moved to San Francisco, I lived in a hacker house with 12 other dudes, and I hustled pretty hard to find some contract work. But when I finally did, it was lucrative. A couple months of work gave me the freedom to travel through India, Thailand, and Japan for 6 months and write my first book, Decentralized Applications. Contract work can free you. It can give you the space you need to think about the impact that you really want to have in the world and experience all the things that you've always wanted to. The second way is to start a business. Now, this is the most difficult, but also the most potentially lucrative way to make money. The chance of succeeding is relatively slim, but you can definitely increase that chance by doing a few things. First of all, your main goal should be to have a positive impact. You have to believe in the cause. Secondary to that should be the money, not the other way. There's a very thin line between the two, but it's such a crucial one. Startups are hard. You are fighting for survival in the market, and any number of uncertainties can occur. But if you have that drive, then it doesn't matter. Your belief in a cause greater than yourself will help you to push through all the hard times, all the rejections. Think about a problem that you want to solve. Close your eyes and envision a world where this problem is solved. And from that vision, work backwards. How do we get to that world? That's where your startup comes in. Marc Andreessen once famously said that software is eating the world. At the same time, AI is eating software. Soon, machine learning will be happening in every single layer of the stack, from operating systems to rendering to networking, all of it. So that means you can just apply AI to some existing idea and boom, startup. You need to be sure that the idea is something that people want. I had a robotics startup in college. I built a team, built a prototype, raised money. But after 8 months of building, we found that our clients didn't really want our product. We could have saved all our time and energy if we had some committed customers from the start. So make sure you have that in an Excel spreadsheet. These big companies like Amazon and Google are buying up AI startups like candy, which is a very lucrative exit strategy. The third way is a full-time job or internship. Start out by working for a smaller company first, where you'll have a lot of responsibilities. You want to optimize for learning. You'll learn a lot in a fast-paced environment, and since you're not used to the comfort of a bigger corporation yet, it'll be easier to do. And please don't do any unpaid internships. If you know how to code, you should be paid for it. The fourth way is to participate in programming contests. You can enter into one of these things as either a team or a single person, and you'll learn a lot. There are several sites online like HackerRank and TopCoder that will pay out prizes to the winners of a given programming challenge. Local hackathons are also a great way to do this. If you can't find one near you, start your own. Call up some potential sponsors, say a company whose API you really like, and say that you're organizing a hackathon that will get programmers to build tools using their software. You get a cut of the earnings, the programmers get to learn, and the company gets more attention. Lastly, the fifth way is to complete bounties. The idea is that people essentially give out a flat fee for someone to fix a bug in their repository. It's like monetizing GitHub issues. You could potentially fix one bounty a week for some fun spending money, or make a living off of it. BountySource and Bountify are two great resources to do this. And that's it. Go forth and make it rain, wizards. Please subscribe for more programming videos. And for now, I've got to get back to the grind. So thanks for watching.